Want to know how to set up stream alerts on Mixer? In this video right here, I'm going to show you how to customize your stream alerts using StreamLabs. Let's dive in. What's going on? It's your boy Santana with Lions Among Sheep, where I bring you guys the best streaming tips and tricks. If it's your first time here and you want to learn how to improve and grow your stream and personal brand, subscribe to my channel and hit the notification bell so you can be notified when I upload a new video every single Tuesday. Setting up stream alerts on Mixer is a great way to entertain your audience as well as getting them to engage with your actual stream. So it's very important that when you set up your alerts that they're on brand and showcase your personality. That way your viewers are more invested into your actual channel. So we're going to be using StreamLabs to be able to power all of our alerts that are going to pop up on our Mixer stream. So the first thing we want to do is we want to go ahead and get logged in with our Mixer account. Once you're logged in, you want to go ahead and come to the left-hand side menu and select Alert Box. Now, this is where we're going to be able to customize all the alerts that appear on Mixer when it comes to follows, subscriptions, donations, hosts, etc., the merch that's purchased if you're using StreamLabs. This is where we're going to customize all the alerts that are going to appear on stream. So the first thing we want to do is we want to come to the general settings. This is the first step to make sure that everything else that we do works the way it needs to. So the only things you want to focus on here is the alert delay. Put that at 5 seconds. This is going to be the delay between the time that somebody does an action to the time that it actually appears on the actual stream. Unlimited alert moderation delay, have that disabled. You don't want to manually approve alerts. It just doesn't make any sense. So you just want to focus on that and leave it disabled. As far as the layout, this is going to be more of your personal preference, how you want the alerts to actually display, whether you want an image on top and a text on the bottom, or the image and then the text over the image, or the image to the left and the text to the right. For the purpose of this video, we're going to do an image above and a text under, so just go ahead and follow along if you want it that way. Alert parries, have that disabled. And profanity filter, this is very important to have active, just because you never know, based on donations, people are able to send messages with their donations. So just in case somebody wants to troll you, you want to make sure that you're at least protected as much as possible. That way you offer the best experience possible to your viewers. So have this, replace bad words with asterisks, have enable standard bad word list. That way you don't have to think about what could be said. And then anonymize names containing bad words as well. And then if you do have any additional bad words that you may want to add or profanity, this is where you would add that. And once you've kind of completed these settings here, you simply want to go ahead and click Save Settings. And now the basic settings for the alert are set up. And now we can go ahead and start customizing the actual follow screens. Okay, so the first thing we're going to do before we go ahead and customize the actual followers alert is we want to go ahead and select this actual widget URL and select Copy. Now you want to go ahead and put this and input it into either OBS or Livestream or StreamLab OBS, whatever platform you're using to actually stream or host your overlays. This is where you want to add the actual browser source. So if you're using Livestream, which this is what I was using prior to using OBS, you simply want to go ahead and select layers. You want to select the plus. You want to come here and you want to select third party integrations. You then want to go ahead and select StreamLabs. And here you want to enter that URL that we just went ahead and copied from StreamLabs. And now here you can see here, this is where your alert box is going to be. So feel free to move this or change it to wherever you like. But once you go back to StreamLabs and you select this test follow, you'll see here that it'll appear whatever we customize. So that way now I can edit this, I can make it smaller, I can change the positioning. So you're able to test the alerts before you actually go live. So it's the same process for OBS. You simply add a browser source and drop the actual link. If you're not sure exactly how to do that, a simple search on Google or YouTube for the actual platform you're using will guide you on how to add the actual alerts. So now that you know how to add the alerts to your actual platform, now we can go ahead and start customizing and testing the actual alert. So the first thing you want to do is you want to make sure that you have alerts enabled. Once that's enabled, you want to look at the layout and you want to select the layout that best defined to the image and the layout that you're going to be using. For the purposes of this video, we're going to do an image up top and a text on the bottom. And then as far as the animation that the alert is going to have, I have it set as fade in and fade out. You can always change this, and in order for you to change it and for it to show effect, you have to make the change and scroll to the bottom and hit save, and then you'll be able to test and it will appear on the platform that you're using. So the next thing is the message template. This is going to be the text that's going to appear when somebody follows your stream. By default, it's set to the name of the user is now following. Feel free to change that to be something a little bit more brandable, like name, welcome to the Curvy Show will be an example. So feel free to use whatever text you feel comfortable using there. The next thing is the text animation. This is going to be how the text is going to be animated. I have it set as bounce. Once again, they have several options for you to select from. Choose the one that you like, test it out, and see what works best. The next thing here is going to be the image and the sound that's going to appear once somebody follows. Now, a lot of times you can have your own custom actual alert screens and you can add them on here. You can create your own overlays or alerts using Canva, which I've shown you in other videos how powerful Canva is. You can go ahead and outsource and hire somebody to create designs for you, or you can search the web for free templates to plug in if you like. However, StreamLabs does offer you a vast variety of imagery that you can use right out of the gate. And if you find one that fits within your brand or your personality, feel free to select those. And once you have that image selected, same thing goes for the actual sound. You can upload your own sound on here, your own MP3s, or you can use some of the sounds and animations that StreamLabs has here selected. So let's go ahead and say this is going to be the image and the sound that we want to use. And then the sound volume, I typically put it at 50%. Feel free to adjust that to your liking. Like I said, you're able to test the sound, the way things look, by using the test button and then having that link installed in your actual platform. The next thing here is the alert duration. Now, I typically found that 6 seconds is a sweet spot. However, for donations, I like to increase this just a little bit longer to give that person more screen time to value them for that actual donation. So the next thing you have here is the alert text delay. I have that at 0 simply because I want the text and the image to appear at the actual same time. The next thing here is the enable custom HTML. Have that disabled. And the only other thing that we're going to go ahead and customize is the font settings. So feel free to choose a font that you like or that fits with your brand. I use Open Sans, it's the easiest to read. As far as the font size, this is going to be predicated on the image you're using, how small it is. So just go ahead and customize this to your liking, change the settings. I have it at 40. Font width, this is the thickness of the actual font. I have it at 700. Text color, white, and then the highlighted color, as you can see here, the highlighted color is going to be the actual name. So when I click test follow, you'll see that it appears here. The highlighted color is going to be the username of the actual person, and what's in white is going to be the text after that. So once you've completed and customized your actual follow alert, you simply hit save settings, and now that alert is going to appear as long as you have that browser source set up in your platform, whether it be OBS, StreamLabs OBS, or Livestream, it would start to appear. And now that you know how to set up one of the alerts, you simply do the same for all the others that you need. And like I said, the process is fairly similar, so just follow along with what we did for follow alerts, and you should be good to go. Now that you know how to set up your stream alerts on Mixer, how do you continue to improve and grow? I've created a Mixer streaming checklist that has some handy tips to get you started off on the right track. The link to download the checklist is below. If you like this video, please let me know by liking it below, subscribe, and share it with a fellow streamer, and comment below with helpful if this video helped you. I'll see you guys next week. You know the motto, hustle, live, repeat.